Now I request our Pro Vice Chancellor, Dr. Pradeep Kumar, to please present a bouquet to welcome our guest, Mr. Raman Aggarwal, as a token of gratitude. We are delighted to have with us today an eminent speaker, Shri Raman Aggarwal, Chairman, Finance Industry Development Council and Senior Vice President, Corporate Affairs, SRFI, Infrastructure Finance Ltd, which is the leading financer of construction and mining equipment in India. Shri Raman Aggarwal has been actively representing the NBFC sector, being a member of Advisory Group to Ministry of Finance and RBI Core Group set up by Ministry of Corporate Affairs and Special Task Force at FICCI. He is the Chairman of National Council on NBFC and Member Managing Committee at ASSOCHAM and the Co-Convener of Finance and Industry Government Interface Panels at Indian Construction Equipment Manufacturers Association. He was the signatory of engagement letter signed by World Bank Group with FIDC. Shri Raman Aggarwal was awarded the Best NBFC Exemplary Leader Award at the ET Now BFSI Awards and 100 Topmost Influential BFSI Leaders Award at the World BFSI Congress in February 2018. He has addressed major events and seminars like Global Convention on Corporate Governance and Sustainability at London IFC's Financial Infrastructure Workshop for the Afghanistan Bank, Eurofinance India 2010-13, the Economic Times Summit on Financial Inclusion, National Summit on NBFCs, and World Auto Congress organized by ASSOCHAM. He has been an invitee to the pre-budget discussion of the Finance Minister with representatives from banking and financial institutions. He is a member of Academic Advisory Council of New Delhi Institute of Management and guest faculty at Institute of Chartered Accountants India and International Management Institute, New Delhi. Shri Raman Aggarwal is Masters in Urban Planning from School of Planning and Architecture, New Delhi, and Bachelor of Civil Engineering from Thapar Institute of Engineering and Technology, Patiala. He has also undertaken a special training program for the personnel of non-banking finance companies at RBI College of Agricultural Banking, Pune. We welcome you, sir. I now request my co-host, Tripti, to introduce our Pro Vice Chancellor, Pradeep Sir, and take things forward. Thank you.
Pro Vice Chancellor, Dr. Pradeep Kumar, holds a doctorate in physics from Jamia Millia Islamia. After working with premier technical institutions in NCR for 15 years as one of working trustees, he started Delhi College of Technology and Management in 2008. At DCTM, he laid out all systems and procedures to impart quality education by creating value addition courses based on the feedback of MNCs. Dr. Pradeep Kumar is an educationist, visionary leader, campaigner with impact for social causes, and with more than 25 years experience in teaching, training and placement, conducting academic and applied research, expertise in corporate affairs, experience in international faculty exchange programs, as well as collaborations with international universities. May I now request sir to please stay forward in few say words and welcome our distinguished guest.
It is my privilege to welcome Shri Raman Aggarwal ji to GU campus. He has a great name as far as NBFC is concerned in India. His opinions, his analysis, his comments are heard at all economic forums and also by the Ministry of Finance. He has contributed a lot in the last 25 years, especially in the area of NBFC. I'm happy he is here to educate us, to show us the path, especially in the area of NBFC. The topic of today's talk is based on entrepreneurship and NBFC. In both the domains, lot of opportunities for the students, for the young students like you, not only for jobs but also for learning experience. I hope there will be a question answer session after the seminar, and we'll be able to clear your doubts in these two verticals. So once again, I welcome Shri Aggarwalji for his valuable time and coming to this campus and addressing group students. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your insightful words. Without much ado, I now request Shri Raman Aggarwal to begin the session. So,
जाते थे तो बुक्स वहीं से लेते थे एंड टू बी अमंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ गलगोटिया यूनिवर्सिटी आई थिंक इज दैट एक्सटेंट नॉस्टैल्जिक आल्सो बिकॉज़ एज़ आई सेड गलगोटिया होल्ड्स अ स्पेशल प्लेस इन एटलीस्ट माय करियर एंड सो व्हेन आई वाज टॉकिंग टू प्रदीप ही रिक्वेस्टेड मी टू कम हियर आई शेयर दिस सीक्रेट लेट मी से टेल यू आल्सो Because I am always waiting for such opportunities. Because you get, that is where I am going to talk about. I love to disrupt myself. Go to routine work, you know, we say morning, go to mails, phone calls, WhatsApp, either now, either now, people calling. Sometimes useful, but majority of the time boring and sharing with you. So it's always interesting to disrupt yourself, come out of that boring routine and be amongst bright, young, energetic minds and share views, but more importantly, listen your views. Because as the Prime Minister also says, now he's planning to hold a youth parliament, then he says, let this India decide how the future of India will be. And I think that's a very, very wise step going forward. So what I'm going to say is that, and at the outset, let me tell you, please feel free, forget about what has been said about me, and as one of you, jahan boring lage, bata, it will change track. Okay? Idea is to at least keep you awake. If I can do that, I think I'll do my job. So I thought, let me talk about disruption. How many of you have heard this word? Disruption. It's the order of the day. Actually, it's the flavor of the day. Unless you learn to disrupt yourself, you cannot progress in today's world. I'm talking. हमारे time पे चलता रहा. We had those set patterns, set syllabuses, set everything. अभी हम आ रहे थे, so we were discussing. I saw your beautiful food court. हमारे time पे दो ढाबे होते थे. We used to just go there, have tea, and you know, chai ke saath matki or a pakora will do, or a samosa will do.
Yes.
But I know you guys need brands, you guys need variety. Idea is to disrupt. Let's get out of this comfort zone. Because if you don't disrupt yourself, let me tell you in my 25 years of experience, and I'll share some personal experiences, there is somebody somewhere working full time to disrupt you. You heard about fintechs? Anybody? Yep, the financial technology players. They're IT people working in the financial sector, and we have this lot of startups which are coming, fintechs. They have become the biggest disruptors of the financial world. This entire concept of lending, which started in India way back, wo mahajan paise dete the gaon mein, evolved to the NBFCs, to the banks, to the lending institutions, then you have multilateral international institutions right up to World Bank. And who are these fintechs? Just few young energetic minds on a platform like Ubers and the Olas or the Airbnbs. They have created platforms. You can go borrow money. Money could be as small as 2000 rupees, could be as petty. Sorry for saying this, for taking your girlfriend for a movie or going out for a nice date. The money is available online at the click of a button, because this is the fantastic toy we have. You guys grew up playing with this. We learned about this few years back, but fortunately we at least tried to adapt. But this is again disruption. So this is the world today. This is a camera, this is a radio, this is my computer, this is my phone, this is everything. So disruption is the order of things. Learn to disrupt yourselves, otherwise somebody will disrupt you one day. So I thought, let me begin. When I was in class 6, this incident I always narrate because it is etched in my mind. I studied in a convent missionary school, so where English was given a lot of importance. No, with due respect, undue importance. To the extent that we were punished. So we had an English teacher, a gentleman called Mr. Augustine. And I would say an encyclopedia in English. And the faculty sitting here would remember Brendan Martin was the Bible for us. Grammar Sarium, Brendan Martin se padte. And he was totally dedicated to ensuring that each one of us learn the right grammar. Once during his class, I had the urge to go to the bathroom. I thought thodi der control karte, but the pressure was too much. So I walked up to him and I said, "Sir, can I go to the bathroom?" I was thinking if that God will come and just say I was about to go. He called me. He said, "Sir, come here." And looked at me. He said, "While you can, but you may not." And then he went on to explain me the difference between can and may. Imagine that line. Adha suna, jo bhi suna. First I rushed to the bathroom, relieved myself, came back, and then gave a thought. Looking back, today I'm 53, touching 54. This can and may is the essence of life. Is the essence of at least corporate life, essence of your future careers. There are so many things, even today, which you can do, but you may not do. Because those are not ethical. Those are not expected. There are a lot of things which you may do, but cannot do. When I say cannot do, doesn't mean you are not capable. Sorry, I am not talking about capabilities. Cannot means the law may not allow you. The law doesn't allow you. This whole history of can and may is also the essence. When I was addressing the conference in London on corporate governance, I touched upon this point. The entire concept of corporate governance is again based on can and may. Lot of things companies may do, which they cannot do, meaning they are not expected to. And that is where we heard, you've seen so many scams happening. And on the other hand, there are so many things which the company can do, but they may not do. And that is where the whole chapter of corporate governance are. So, what should be the philosophy of building career is a judicious decision between this can and me. Sara khel isi can. Because corporate world is a dirty old world. Sorry, I know you guys want to be in corporate world. Soon, you're almost, gearing up, dashing to rush to the corporate world. But once you are there, you will learn the other side of the story, because corporate world means targets. Everything runs on targets. I remember a joke, a man was driving down the hill, beautiful weather, fantastic scenery, and the road was very well laid. He had the urge to drive fast. Right? Again, that can and may story. So he was but hesitant. Risky accident was at that. Suddenly the heavens spoke. And God said, "Son, don't worry, your time is not yet up." He said, "Fantastic." So he pressed the pedal, accelerated, enjoying the beauty, as fate would have it, met with an accident, died. His soul went up to heaven, furious. What you told me, my time is not up. God said, son, even I need to meet my targets. This is the joke which goes into the corporate world. So those are the pressures you will work in. At the beginning of every financial year, April annual, we follow the financial year, not the calendar year, which is the norm internationally. April onwards, targets will be set, and then your entire year running around trying to meet those targets, because your PMS depends on that. So, in your efforts to build a career, I'm sure majority of you would also have a view, achieve MBA degree from a good university, reputed university, join a big company, preferably an MNC, right? That's the flavor. Have a good pay packet, have a good comfort life, be a globetrotter, move around the world, enjoy life, right? That's the dream. What if I also tell you, I'm not against this, sorry, I'm myself working in the corporate world. I'm not against this. But what if I tell you that there is a negative side? And that is, I'm sure you all know, you're all very much aware, as I said, you have this toy 24/7 available. That the world over, the study shows there is a heavy, heavy concentration of wealth in the world. And it is more true in a country like India. A select few have so much wealth that there is a huge disparity. Right? Now think it this way. The dream which you have, which I just spoke about, are you not adding to the problem? Yes? You are working for someone else, building someone else's wealth. Yes, you are getting a good pay packet. Again, I'm not saying don't do this, but the idea is to present the other side. So you guys are best judges. You know, I am nobody to tell you ki ye kar. I can only suggest, advise, show you the other sides, and then leave it on you to take a call. So here in I bring in the concept of entrepreneurship. Be your own masters. Right? It's good to be, you know, to gain experience, to work under somebody, learn the tricks of the trade. That's also very important. But do carry that vision of entrepreneurship without sounding political. Let me tell you that for the first time, entrepreneurship in a country like India has been given so much thrust and importance. And let's accept that. This whole idea of Startup India, Make in India, Stand Up India, Digital India, I will include Clean India or the Swachh Bharat also part of that, are not mere political slogans. It's actually unfortunate, again with due respect, it's a profession. Media in our country has played a very, very negative role at times. The way things are projected are not done in the right light. Never ever in the history of our country, these have become national goals, national objectives. No, general hota tha, yes. But to have a mission at the national level, and there are efforts being made to support entrepreneurship. Be your own masters, do something of your own, and be what we say as job providers rather than job seekers. Okay. The sector which I come from, we have mastered the art of funding the unfunded. Because financial inclusion is a buzzword which is very fashionable. We've been doing it for the last 100 years now. And that is the idea, is to create entrepreneurship. Support people who in turn will be able to support at least 2 or 3 more people. Build your career, build their career. So that's another side of the story. As I said, a writer, I'm not saying that working for somebody else is bad, but have this concept also in mind. There were a lot of doubts raised, you know, when this entire concept of startups failed, because let me also share, I know you would be aware, that I think almost 85% to 90% of these startups fail. Right? And it's nothing wrong in that, nothing strange in that. Any new venture, any new idea, it's not necessary that it will succeed. Because to succeed, there are a lot of elements to it. Of course, one is the idea itself, but more importantly, how sustainable is that idea? It may sound very attractive today, right? But how sustainable is it? That is the key. Because you will have pressures, there will be ups and downs. Today, there was a time IT was like everywhere. Today, IT is one of them. Not a big deal. There was a time when India was like, IT means India. And IT means the job is done. You don't need to look anywhere else. How the world has changed. And I often cite this example. I know you guys are very smart using the Swiggy's, the Zomato's. What are these? Desi bhasha mein baat kare to delivery boys. Correct? I'm not please denigrating everybody, those guys. So what I'm saying is it's a brilliant idea. Thought out, made sustainable. Agar yehi baat main apne father ko bolta, he would have kicked me out of the house. That time. So, what are these? These are delivery boys. Working on two wheelers, wearing fancy clothes, carrying a nicely designed bucket on the two wheelers and a bag, and delivering pizzas and food stuff. But they made it. This brings to the other point that, so what could be the key elements? Passion. Number one could be passion. Whatever idea, whatever you have in your mind, first of all, you have to be passionate. Now, passion is a word which again I think is not used in the right sense. If you ask me what is to be passionate, main bolta hu, unless tumhe aake koi ye bole ki tum pagal ho, you are not passionate. Be passionate to the extent of going crazy. Unless your friend comes and tells you that you have gone mad, you are crazy. I don't know how many of you, Einstein was the craziest person ever lived in on this earth. Absolute, Dutch, stupid fellow. He was totally mindless, but a genius, because he was mad. Same applies to many, many people around. And I need not say there are so many examples around. Unless somebody tells you you are mad, understand you are not passionate. Passion, according to me, means go mad. Of course, next, think out of the box. Because those old stereotypes will not work. There will be many others to beat you. Think out of the box. Be passionate, be crazy, and the most important, nothing is small. Everything can be small, everything can be big. Because this entire thing of big and small, the corporate mein bahut chalta hai, badi company hai, choti company hai, you know, big balance sheet, small balance sheet, big pay packet, small pay packet, it's all relative. This old saying, you know, there is a line, so you want to make it, isko chota kar do, bina touch kiye. It's a badi line kiye. But okay, this becomes small, so everything is relative. to tell you some live examples of how small, small things can matter. There is this, how many of you play tennis? Anybody here plays tennis or follows tennis? Oh, football is flavor, I think. Football actually did me cricket overtake, but we were discussing. But tennis, there were two legends of tennis, I don't know if you've heard their names, Boris Becker and Andre Agassi. Boris Becker was a tall German player, and Andre Agassi was an American, short, but very agile, very a classic player. I mean, he was my favorite. So what happened? This is Andre Agassi telling this story post his retirement. He said, when I first played against Boris, Boris was a tall German. And he said, man, when he served, I could not figure the head and tail. It just flew past me. I just could see Bahamian. He was so fast. And said, in the first two matches, Boris beats me, hands down. He was very disturbed because Andre Agassi was one of the leading players. So what to do? He started watching his videos. Right? One after the other. He said, kuch toh hoga. And then he realized something. He saw something. He said, I realized when Boris was just about to serve, he would stick his tongue out like this. And if the tongue was on the right, he would serve in, sorry, not right, left. If it was on the left, he would serve on the left side of the court. If it was straight, he would serve down the court. He said, I thought I spotted, but then he replayed and watched many other matches. And he said, yes, that's true. This guy does it. It's a habit. But what was the bigger challenge? Not having caught Boris, but to ensure that Boris should not know I have caught him. Next nine matches, Agassi beat Boris hands down. And then Agassi says, post Boris's retirement also, both of us were sitting in a bar one evening having a drink together, and I broke the story to Boris. He fell down from the chair. He said, man, I used to go home and tell my wife, this guy reads my mind. I never knew he reads my tongue. So, ek tongue ne, jeep ne khel kar diya. Can there be anything more smaller or pity than this? Nothing to do with the game. Just his habit of sticking the tongue out. Another classic example. General Motors, you all know. Chevrolet Guardian, you see in the Indian books. Old times, an American bought a new Chevrolet car and brought home the car. In the family, they had a tradition that after dinner, they used to have ice cream as the dessert. So he said, we used to normally have vanilla. So he said, it's Nayi Gaadi Aayi, so let's try the chocolate flavor. So he went up to the department store in the new car, parked the car, went to the store, picked up chocolate ice cream, came back, ignition on, kiya, gaadi start kiya. New car. He tried to twice, nothing happened. Then maybe new gaadi hai, battery rating hai, chakkar hoga, so pushed it, car started, went home. Next day he said, okay, let's go back to the vanilla flavor. He went to the store, bought vanilla flavor, with a heavy heart, drag the ignition, that is, car start. He came back. Next day chocolate, car can start. Next day vanilla, car starts. He did it 4 times, 5 times, it happened. Man, this is crazy. He said, how stupid I would look even if I tell them, they will say, Pagal. How can an ice cream run the car? So he was thinking, but he said, no, it's an issue. I have paid money. I need to have a product for which I have paid for. He wrote an email. He wrote a letter to the customer care department. So one, he never overlooked the problem, however small it was or stupid it was. But look at the other side. Put yourself as in charge of the customer care of General Motors. And somebody writes this letter to you. What will be your first reaction? Thank you. You don't need it. There are many customers, Gaia actually to create, my market is fine. Why should I worry about it? No. They had a technician who flew down to that guy's residence. Went up to his house. He said, chalo, let's buy it. Went in the car. He was, you know, accompanying him right up to the store, coming back. They did it two or three times, and bingo, sorted out. So what happens? You all guys today, this is the world of stores. So as a marketing sense, whatever products are of daily need are generally kept near the end. For example, I go for morning walk, wife ka phone aata hai, bread le aana, to rush, gaye bread uthai bhaag. The products which are not so much in demand, piche rakhe. So vanilla being a very common flavor, was kept near to the entrance. Chocolate, a slightly high-end flavor, was kept at the far end of the store. So it was the difference, time lag, between turning the ignition off and reigniting it on, that matter. Only that time lag. Nothing to do with ice cream. Problem identified, ek engineer aur bulaya, done, sorted out, problem solved. So, nothing is small, nothing is big. Wo small ka big ho jayega, you will never know. You know, as I said, what was Swiggy? What was Flipkart? But Flipkart has changed and shaken the world just because of that Walmart deal. It has changed the entire concept of startups. It has changed the entire outlook of the world towards Indian startups. Young guys, Sachin Bansal, Vinny Bansal, are like one of you. Like you sit here, you would not even recognize them. But look at that. They're billionaires today. So nothing is small. Nothing is big. Don't ignore anything. Be open. Aware. I know, awareness-wise, you guys are fantastic. But a concept for that tend to be careless. Never do that. Another important aspect, in today's world, it has become much more relevant in our country. Have you heard of the insolvency law? This government, for the first time in India, we have had an actual law on insolvency and bankruptcy. Crudely speaking, what is it? It is an official, legally accepted exit route available to any business. And I know it sounds strange, but I say this to all youngsters, that whenever you plan to start something, as I said, be passionate, die tomorrow, plan something, your business plan, but also lay out an exit route for yourself. It is very important. I know I may sound slightly negative here, but don't get stuck. That is where today the Jet Airways, the JPs, the Malyas, the Nirvs have got stuck. Intention alag hai, but they got stuck in the business. They could not find an exit route. And what has resulted, it is in a mess we all know. Have an exit route planned out for yourself. Nikalne ka rasta. And officially, legally accepted. Patni gali se nikalne wala nahi. The one which the Malayas and the Virats have adopted. No. Acceptable routes. There are. And this law gives you this option. So when you plan something, when you plan, make your business plans or your projections or your ideas, also look at the exit route. let me say it in your language. I know because my son, my daughter wants to say anything. Papa, chill. Right? Take a chill pill. That's the point. Don't get stuck. Chill. Get up. Move on. Move on. Ye nahi to kuch aur karega. That is equally important in today's world. And unless, this is one side, the other side is, unless you dive deep down. Daso mein ghi mein sar kadhai mein, main to kehta hu sar se pair tak kadhai mein. Into it. Classic example is the concept of childbirth in a watery environment today. Because children are natural, babies are natural swimmers, born swimmers. 9 months a baby swims in the mother's womb. We are born swimmers. वो अलग बात है कि आज भी हमें swimming नहीं आती. That's because we adapted ourselves that. So unless you dive, swimming नहीं आएगी. मार दो चला. देखें. Because if you think there are so many ifs, so many buts, there will be many to encourage you, many to discourage you. और मेजॉरिटी बोलेंगे देख लो जो ठीक लगता है करो. तो बॉटम लाइन क्या है, जो ठीक लगता है करो. राइट, अपने आप में क्लियर रखो क्या करना है. नहीं करना तो कहां चिल पिल लेनी और निकल जाना पतली गली से. एन ऑफिशियल एक्सेप्टेबल रिस्पेक्टेबल रूट. सो दीज थिंग्स विल हेल्प यू a lot. Okay. One more thing I would like to touch upon is a lot of changes will happen. Kya hota hai? Often it is a human practice, nothing wrong. I am working in a company, I have a nice pay packet, or I have my own venture, it's running well, giving me good returns. Fat bank balance is there, अच्छी गाड़ी है, घर है, you are enjoying with your girlfriend or boyfriend, अच्छा चल रहा है, world is fine, comfort zone में, right? No. Again I come to the first point, disrupt yourself. Never sit in the comfort zone because personal experience बताता हूँ. If you don't do it, I warn you. There is somebody working full time to disrupt you. It happened with me. I started my career in financial sector. We had our own family in MBAs. 20 years I was there. Achhi company, small company but doing very well. Comfort zone, everything fine. At the age of 46, I had to leave the out. No hard feelings for anybody. Circumstances were such, I had to move up. Slate clean over. Washed. Everything is washed. It's a blank board. I remember sitting with my wife, and that was the time my son was, he appeared for his 12th exam, my daughter was in class 10. Planning बच्चों के करियर बना रहे and here you are disrupted out. So we were sitting in a mall having coffee. Wife asked me क्या करना, अपनी कंपनी start कर. I said the time is not right. For the last 10 years, 15 years, I have been representing the sector. People say a lot of good things about me. कि बहुत अच्छा है, बहुत समझ है, बहुत जानते हो, बहुत पता है. I want to test it. Actual है कि lip service. सर बताएंगे मेजॉरिटी लिप सर्विस होती है. मेजॉरिटी टाइम्स इट इज लिप सर्विस, यू नो पीपल विल प्रेज यू बाद में गाली होती है. बट ओके, लेट मी टेस्ट माय सेल्फ, लेट मी पुट माय सेल्फ इन द मार्केट. बिग रिस्क. इमेजिन आई एम 46, माय सन इज हैज अपीयर्ड फॉर 12th बोर्ड्स, डॉटर हैज अपीयर्ड फॉर 10th क्लास एग्जाम्स. मैं बच्चों का करियर बना रहा. Okay, current where I am working, I knew the these MDs and this chairman for 15 years. I just put an SMS. Sunil ji, I want to meet you. They based in Calcutta. I said, okay, I'm coming to Delhi Saturday, mil lete. Woh bhai coffee shop pe aa jao, coffee piyenge, baat karenge. I said, fine. Chale gaye. I told you, Sunil ji, aisa hua. I said, why don't you join us? I said, okay, the job is done. But why I am narrating you this is, whatever I am today, whatever you heard about me today, at least 80% has happened post that episode. Now imagine I was in a very comfort zone, sab kuch achha chal raha tha, family bahut achhi chal rahi thi, business bahut achha tha. Disruption hua, and I chose to further disrupt myself. Because what this gave me was, if I had a platform as the size of this stage before that date, this is 2011, I'm telling you the date. Now the platform which I have is bigger than this university. All due credit to my current employers, I have great respect for them. Perhaps they could sense that, maybe vision of that, they could sense it. But the major point I'm telling you here is, I chose to come out of my comfort zone. I chose to disrupt myself, although the initial disruption was brought by somebody else. Koi kar raha tha kaam, mujhe pata hi nahi tha. Main to bahut happy, khush, ki life bahut achhi hai, enjoying. Suddenly, one day out, boss, niklo. And I tell you, Chairman, in the last years, you have this annual company events. So he was called up on the stage. He walked up and said, okay, friends, what if I tell you that from tomorrow, none of you will have your job? So, aade to kursi pe gir gaye. Ye kya ho gaya? So his idea was this. Make yourself competent enough. ठीक है ये सब होगा राइट रॉन्ग एथिकल नॉन एथिकल वो सब झगड़ा अलग है पर होगा जरूर होगा और अगर नहीं होगा तो यू विल नॉट राइज ये भी पक्का है रीड एनी ग्रेट पर्सन्स हिस्ट्री किसी भी फील्ड में यू विल सी दैट जेंटलमैन और अ लेडी हैड सफर्ड मेजर डिसरप्शंस इन देयर लाइफ मेजर गेम चेंजिंग डिसरप्शंस क्या थे क्या बन गए मेरे साथ बहुत बड़ी प्रॉब्लम क्या होती है यू हर्ड बाय एजुकेशन लेट मी अगेन से आई एम अ पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट इन टाउन प्लान आई एम अ ग्रेजुएट इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग एंड हियर आई एम वर्किंग इन द फाइनेंशियल सेक्टर एडवाइजिंग गवर्नमेंट एडवाइजिंग आरबीआई इन द फाइनेंशियल सेक्टर वेन चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स बुलाते हैं तो वो I tell you one very interesting story also. It's a secret I'm sharing with you. My boss, that my chairman, even today lives in this illusion that I'm a CA. I have to often tell him, I'm not a CA. Oh, you are not? I said no. Achha, I thought you are a I always thought you are a CA. So, क्या हो क्या बन जाएगा यू डोंट नो एंड इट्स नॉट दैट यू नो बीइंग अ आई वुड से दैट माय डिग्री इज गॉन वेस्ट एज अ सिविल इंजीनियर और टाउन प्लानिंग आई नो कहां पर वेयर इज इट हेल्पिंग मी बिकॉज आई एम डूइंग दिस इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कहां से आता है एवरीथिंग रिलेटिंग टू सिविल इंजीनियरिंग एंड टाउन प्लानिंग सिंपल नथिंग इज वेस्ट नथिंग गोज वेस्ट प्लीज लगता है यू फील डिजेक्टेड कि सब बेकार हो गया क्या कराया गया गोबर हो गया कूड़े में गया नो नथिंग विल गो वेस्ट इट विल हिट यू वन डे सो बी अवेयर बी पैशनेट बी ओपन थिंक आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स एंजॉय योर लाइफ बट नेवर बी कॉम्प्लेसेंट इनफ टू सिट इन अ कंफर्ट जोन और चल गाड़ी चल रहा करो अपने आप को 5 करोड़ डिसर्व मजा आए बहुत मजा आए because I'm telling you, जो जितना मजा मुझे पिछले 7 years में आया है, पूरी life में नहीं आया. I have enjoyed. I'm having a ball. I can tell. Beautiful. मजा आता है. Office जाके मजा आता है. Have you heard anybody saying that? To the extent ki I didn't know this Monday was a holiday, mein office pahunch gaya. And the security guard bhaga bhaga gaya, sir, main aapke liye light jala deta hu. Maine kaha, kyun bhaiya, meri liye light ko jala de, kaise sir, aaj chutti hai. Dr. Sakranti ki aaj chutti hai. Hai wo, acha chutti hoti, kabhi to hui nahi thi. Then he showed me the calendar, sir, dekho. So it's like that, you know, life is beautiful. Finally, let me also say one thing. As you grow tall, as you grow in stature, as you grow in your bank balances, equally jitna upar ja rahe ho, go deep down also. Utne apne aap ko firmly grounded rakho. Humbleness. I don't know how many of you know. You've heard of what happened 26/11, Taj Hotel.
Yes.
The legendary, first cycle this day you also know it. The legendary JRD Tata. Every Tata Group company started by JRD. Every Tata Group company started by JRD was always for a social objective. Started off as a social. But of course, being a corporate, it had to make profits. But the objective was social. Classic example, prior to independence, JRD with his one of the best friends went to have a coffee in a 5-star restaurant. He saw the board, dogs and Indians not allowed. He came back furious and said, I will start a 5-star hotel chain, Indian hotel chain for Indians. Look at the Taj Group. My favorite. I go anywhere in the world, holiday, work, everywhere, blindly touch. No match to this their hospital. No match. Indian Hotels Company. The legacy has passed on to Ratan Tata. 26/11, Taj Mahal Hotel, Mumbai. What happened? When he visited the hotel next day, obviously he was in tears. But then he made some mind-boggling aside. Every time I say I have a lump in my throat. You know what he said? He said, every employee of this hotel, even if he has worked for one day, but was present that time when the attack happened, right? Entire medical expenses for your treatment is on me. But hold on, this is very small. The big thing is to come next. Next step. In sub-employees ke, all their children, entire education, lifelong, in any part of the world, will be on me. Brilliant. I mean, if you see that man today, he would fall to his feet. That humble he is. That grounded he is. And the legacy goes on. There are so many stories. Tata Steel Jamshedpur, right? Diwali gifts baantte hain. Normal corporates mein kya hota hai? Bosses ek decide kar lete hain gifts, sabko mil jayega, right? No. HR head was secretly instructed. Send the workforce, kuch aadmi chune gaye. Send them to each and every employee's house. Talk to the lady of the house. Talk to the children of the house. What do they need? Un sabko wo Diwali gift individually diye gaye. Agli Diwali. Super. Tatas are not very good paymasters, I'm telling you. Pay packets mein ko bahut great nahi hai. Theek hai, therefore, TCS still enjoys the status it has today. But they care for their employees. You are like a family, actual family. Tata is a family. People will not leave Tata unless they have some compelling reason. And that is where. And the man is so humble. I know because when he was on the board of RBI, आरबीएस में मुझे ऑफिसर्स बताते थे कि सिर्फ वो बोर्ड मीटिंग में आते थे, ही यूज्ड टू सेल्फ ड्राइव हिज कार, अपनी मर्सिडीज खुद चला कर, नो शॉफ्ट. अनदर एग्जांपल, आई थिंक इट वाज 2013, आई वाज फ्लाइंग फ्रॉम दिल्ली टू पुणे. What should I say? I was flying the king of good times at that time. No longer a good time. And typical early morning flight, so I prefer the window seat always. Chai peeke so gaye. Aadha, because early morning you have to rush. 4 baje utho, 5 baje airport bhago. I was half asleep. There was an old man sitting. I was on the window seat, the aisle seat. Which ki seat khali? First row, 10. Right? I didn't realize. I was also half asleep. Almost on the end, when the, you know, the captain announced we're about to, you know, descent has started, we're going to land. So this cabin crew came and the lady asked, Mr. Murthy, would you like to have something? Narayan Murthy is sitting. Mr. Narayan Murthy. Absolutely so humble, grounded, no throwing weight, nobody would even make out that this gentleman is Narayan Murthy. Jitna upar jaoge, उतने अपने आप को होल्ड टू द ग्राउंड. यू विल बी लव, यू विल बी केयर, यू विल बी रिस्पेक्टेड. यू शुड कमांड रिस्पेक्ट, डोंट डिमांड रिस्पेक्ट. रिस्पेक्ट इज व्हाट व्हेन यू कमांड, नॉट व्हेन यू डिमांड. डिमांड में तो हर पे देगा, ऐसे देके भी दे देगा, अदरवाइज भी दे देगा. किसी के लिए कुछ काम कर दोगे वो तुम्हें रिस्पेक्ट करेगा. But command, these are the names. I don't know, I have never met Ratan Tata, let me tell you. I have, JRD of course was not long before. But see the kind of respect they command even today. See, there are many other names. Azim Premji, brilliant man. Such great philanthropist name. Whatever they earn, kitna wo society ke liye karte hain. Amazing, amazing work they do. So please, ensure this humbleness should not. That is the basic virtue of humanity. Insaan ki sabse badi fitrat yehi. Jitna upar uthoge, utna agar grounded rahoge, to it's a different game altogether. You never know kahan se kab kya ho jayega. You just can't imagine. And it gives you so much pleasure. When some such things happen to you, it gives you so much pleasure. So you must have heard WhatsApp, maybe there was a story going around of this is Sudha Murthy's, you know.
Yeah.
When she used to adopt, she adopted a girl child who was sent, who went to US. And there was a very recent video where Mrs. Sudha Murthy visited her college, university, and one of her professors got up and namaste kiya. She held his hands. And she fell on her on his feet. Ki sir, aap to guru ho. I know, is age pe nahi lagta. Hum bhi teachers ko badi gaali lene ka. But you will remember. One day it will hit you. One day it will hit you. Mark my words. As I am narrating you, my class 6 teacher, you know, we used to, matlab used to say, ki kya teacher hai. उस टाइम पे 50 में से हाईएस्ट 35 होते थे. बिकॉज द एंटायर, इमेजिन दैट गाय मार्किंग द इंग्लिश पेपर इन अ रेड फाउंटेन पेन और लाल करते थे पेन. ही यूज्ड टू मार्क एवरी कॉमा, फुल स्टॉप, सेमी कोलन, कोलन, एवरीथिंग. स्पेंड 2 मिनट्स विद एवरी स्टूडेंट, गिव अ नॉक ऑन हेड, सन यू हैव इन एपी और मेहनत वर्क हार्ड. उस टाइम लगता था यार क्या पागल के पल्ले पड़ गए. It hits you such. You will remember. And you will, again, let me connect. You will remember the teacher who was the craziest. Jisko sabse zyada aaj galiyan nikalte ho, usi ko yaad rakho. Aur ye hota hai. Attend, not now, but someday it will come in your life. So I think these were the few things I thought I'll share with you. Because, again, one of my, a man whom I have great admiration, the great Dr. Kalam, 2 things he said. that there is nothing called as darkness. There is nothing in this world called as darkness. There is nothing in this world called as cold. Darkness is only absence of light. By itself, there is nothing called as darkness. It is a mere absence of light which is called darkness. He had a fight with his teacher. He was kicked out of the class. But he was bent upon saying that, yes sir, that is the truth. And he was the one who said, when somebody said, you know, somebody wished him a happy birthday. He said, you know what is so great about birthday, so special about birthday? Because that is the only day when I cried and my mother smiled. Otherwise, have any one of you sitting here seen your mother smile when you cry? Never. But your birthday, the day when you were born, was that historic day. When your mother smiled and you cried. So these are few things which will just remember that. I'm not saying some things life will teach you. Bottom line is, zyada bore nahi karunga. Apne aap ko focus rakho, dive maro, out of the box karo, world enjoy karo, ghoomo, sab kuch karo. पर कभी भी अपने आप को कंफर्ट में एक जगह बैठ के बस ना कि बस यार हो गया बस बिकॉज दैट इज अ पॉइंट विच इज अफेक्टिंग टुडेज जनरेशन लेट मी टेल यू विद ड्यू रिस्पेक्ट बिकॉज वी हैव सीन व्हेन वी सी दिस साइड ऑफ द स्टोरी व्हेन वी हैव पीपल कमिंग इन स्टूडेंट्स हु कम आउट फ्रॉम सम गुड यूनिवर्सिटीज हु सडनली आर ऑफर्ड वेरी वेरी हाई पे पैकेट्स यू नो You see that change, वो दिमाग में चल जाता है. That culture is not there. They don't want to learn. They are on the lookout कि अच्छा इससे बड़ा pay packet कहाँ मिलेगा. You know, so that is not. This is not work. Short term, बड़ा short term लगता है. Money earn करने के लिए ज़िंदगी पड़ी. You will have so many opportunities. Earning money is not. There is no dearth of money. When somebody says India is a poor country, rubbish. We are very rich. If somebody says ki jobs nahi hai, to an extent correct. But I don't fully agree. Because let me also share this entire statistics which people talk about, jobs, etc. Obviously, you know a lot of things are missed up. That's wonderful. We are the most creative country in the world. In our town planning, we used to be taught, you know, taught informal sector was a subject. And I remember my professor used to show us pictures, which you see in daily life. When you go to a juice ka shop, how beautifully and colorfully the fruits are stacked together. Kaiga usko wo kaat ke kisi shape mein bana dega. How efficiently a hawker will carry 10 things on one cycle. And he will just sit on the seat and efficiently work on everything and serve it. This is genuinity, this is creativity, this is innovation. But only the pity is that this has not been formalized. Right? Coming back to the story of delivery boys, they formalized it, they institutionalized it. They converted it into a business idea, a proposition, which was sustainable, worth growing. And today you have dollars being pumped into it. The world is looking at it. Kuch kami nahi hai. Please, I am the most, that way I love to be optimistic. There is nothing, no dearth, no dearth of jobs, no dearth of opportunities, no dearth for earning money. You will have no dearth for moving around. You will have enough. Aaj ki duniya to hai. I say this, in this world, unless break those geographical barriers, they have lost meaning. No work, no business or opportunity can make you stick in one place. No. Today you are here, there, tomorrow you will be somewhere else. There are so many opportunities. Whatever your mind tells you, do it, but do it very, 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 very passionately. That's the crux of this story. I'll end here this part, but I'll take this opportunity to also quickly present before you the sector which I come from, and there is a reason for it, because this is also a career opportunity for me. So I thought, and I know not many people know about this. How many of you know about NBFCs? I know we news may be things, that's a different story. But otherwise, what is an NBFC? Non-banking finance network. Right? Galgotias can But crudely speaking, these companies are into lending business. Right? Now it could be anything and everything. It could be a personal loan, it could be a car loan, two-wheeler loan, tractor loan, truck loan, equipment loan, excavator, backhoe loader, cranes, or SMEs, small business loans, housing loans. All these are part of NBFC business. So today, as of September 30th, 2018, there are 10,000 NBFCs in India. This number is coming down also, slowly. But important point is, out of which 9,800 are small and medium. Another classic example of entrepreneurship, because all these companies are family-run businesses working in smaller areas across the country. What we call as doing niche segment lending. They have specialized in certain aspects. Ek bhi ye story hai. The 276, right, is a systemically important, what RBI says. The criteria is that their asset size, you understand the asset base? Total asset base of that company is more than 500 crores, right? But 276 jo companies hai, by number 10% se bhi kam hogi, right? They control 90% of the market share. They are so big. Next slide. Read the last sentence. The total balance sheet size of the NBFC sector as on 30th September stood at 26 lakh crores. We are number 3 in the system after banks and mutual funds, the AMCs. We are bigger than the insurance players, we are bigger than the cooperative or the other banks. And some of the NBFCs today, at least 5 I know, their balance sheet size beats some of the banks' balance sheets. So my own company, Shrey, Shrey Infrastructure as a whole is a 65,000 crore worth. Shrey Equipment Finance is 30,000 crore book size. We are number one in the country for equipment financing. We are number one. We hold 30%. So every third construction equipment you see down the road is funded by Shrey. Whether it's an excavator, backhoe loader, or a crane, or whatever equipment you see on the highway construction, road construction, dam construction, building construction, mining, most of equipment, every third equipment is funded by Shrey. Similarly, some of the NBFCs have become specialists. So for example, if somebody wants to take a truck loan, the two names which are prominent are Sundaram and Shriram. You would have heard these names. They are South-based companies. They specialize in truck finance. Now Shriram is a classic example. Imagine a company which is today, I think, if not number one, at least number two. Yeah, Bajaj has just overtaken. At least number two in the Indian NBFC market. Their balance sheet size is more than 1 lakh crore. But their business model is what? Second-hand vehicle finance. Used. Imagine kya kiya hoga. What they have done is, you know, you'll be surprised. Shriram organizes trucks ke ramp shows hote. I sound crazy? Right? So, mere baat aagi na, jab tak crazy nahi hoge, successful nahi. The idea is absolute crazy. What they do? Truck liya, second hand, usko refurbish karte. Refurbishing is not only painting and building, but actually refurbishing. And those photographs and all, they will put them at one place, but then they will organize digital ramp shows. across. They will organize truck malls, truck melas. So वहाँ buyers आते हैं, bidding होती है. इमें वहीं के वहीं truck लिया, वहीं के वहीं financing हो गई, सब कुछ हो गया, आप truck लेके घर चलो. Similarly, Mahindra, they have mastered the art of financing truck. Number one in the country. SREI equipment. You go to the likes of Reliance, they are masters in the SME funding. Muthut, Manapuram, naam sune? Based in Kerala. What if I tell you, Muthut and Manapuram put together, unke paas jitna gold hai, wo kai countries ke sovereign gold holdings ke se bhi zyada hai. Put together. Only these two companies, the amount of gold they hold in them. They fund against gold. Radio pad aate na 5 minute mein, right? When I went to Kerala first time, long back, I met Mr. George Muthut. So I asked him, Vinka sir, ye aap karte sir, yes. They actually do it, 5 minutes. Only 5 minutes it takes. But people don't know the other side, which is even more beautiful. Jab paisa repay ho jata hai, to 5 minute mein gold wapas nikal jata hai. I had that picture, they would be having a centralized chest hoga, heavily guarded, so wo centralized hoga. He said, no boss, agar centralized karenge to 5 minute mein kar hi nahi sakte. Every branch has a chest. Every branch has an authorized valuer sitting there. Who will test the valuation, the purity aur value lagata hai. Usi base pe loan disperse hota hai. Done. Job is done. Pure. I mean, NBFCs have been the masters in this game. And just for the people who are in the finance interested, some of the financial parameters I thought I'll share with you. So the growth in balance sheet size, 17.2%, March 18.6%. Imagine in this scenario also, 18% ki growth hai, right? Profitability, net profit, 16.2%. NPS, you all know, yes? Non-performing assets. What is NPA? जैसे घर में कोई आदमी बीमार हो जाता है, उसके लिए एक्स्ट्रा पैसे रखते हैं, प्रोविजनिंग करते हैं. इसी तरह हमारे जब लेंडिंग फैमिली में कोई लोन बीमार हो जाता है, उसके लिए प्रोविजनिंग करनी पड़ती है. तो जो NPA levels है, that is 6%. Whereas banking sector is grappling with somewhere around 12-13%. So if I am throwing these parameters to tell you that the sector is a very healthy sector. It's growing very fast, but it is healthy, right? Whatever happened recently, the ILFS crisis which happened was a one-off thing. Because only I can tell you, not going into too much details, that the likes of ILFSs are only 7 in number in India, out of 10,000. Because they are into what they call as long-term infra financing, which is a long-term project funding. And there they had certain issues. Of course, there was management and governance issues also. But that cannot be taken as a representation for the sector. So the battle goes on. Even yesterday I was at North Block talking to ministry on this, so this goes on. But sector?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please.
Just suppose I have started my startup. My brand is fatcrew.com. My focus and my business model is the dropshipping model.
Sorry?
Dropshipping model.
Okay.
Dropshipping. I mean to say that I will purchase the goods and product from the China and I will export to USA. Because if I thinking about to export in our India, I will have to pay the GST. Because it is a startup, so I will have to pay the GST in the previous time. So would you please brief me something about it and how to deal the GST? And if I am exporting the product to USA, so okay. It is very easily to without the GST and T number I can export the goods from China to USA with the help of vendors from the China. And you can also use the help of Alibaba and AliExpress, they are supporting me. So would you please help me about it?
I will answer your question and also tell you one more thing. First of all, again with due respect, you are today sounding like a chartered accountant. I tell you why. In many of the such occasions when I happen to share about technical NBFC regulation laws, चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स का एक सवाल होता है, फोकस, हाउ टू बाईपास द लॉ, राइट? आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट्स रॉन्ग, बट आई हैव अ डिफरेंट टेक ऑन दैट एंड दैट रिलेट्स टू योर क्वेश्चन. आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट जीएसटी ही देना है, बट टू डेवलप अ बिजनेस मॉडल with the basic concept of trying to bypass something doesn't sound good to me. Right? I'm again, as I said, galat sahi kuch nahi hota, I'm telling you my viewpoint since you've asked for it. Right? And in this world, since the geographical barriers have lost meaning, you are free to do that. But one question I can add there, that this cannot be sustainable. It may work today, it will not be sustainable. Why? Because if it works, right, you will agree you will not be the only one doing this. There will be many. Now imagine, put yourself in government's shoes, and the day you come ki hamari country mein aisa ho raha
hai,
kya ho? Somebody will somewhere make a new law to ensure this thing is checked. उसको हम नाम कुछ भी लेंगे, चाइनीज गुड्स आ रहे हैं इंडिया में हो रहा है या सब कुछ, ट्राइंग टू रेट टैक्स. द बॉटम लाइन इज दैट डोंट डेवलप अ मॉडल ऑफ एन आइडिया व्हिच इज बेस्ड प्राइमरीली ऑन बाईपासिंग अ लॉ. बेटर टू कंप्लाई एंड देन डू इट. व्हाई आई सेड दिस, सिंस योर पॉइंट हियर, पॉइंट ऑफ डिबेट इज जीएसटी, व्हाइल जीएसटी मे पिंच, right? But today, at least I can tell you one of my experience, that if GST is at a rate which is pinching you, my straight advice is go to the government, I'll give you the reference, talk to them, or agar genuine hoga wo rate kam ho jayega. Maine khud personally two categories mein rate ek meeting mein kam karaya. Not that I am influenced or I know somebody, no. If the credit not goes to me, credit goes to the government here. They are very receptive. And you would see, GST mein jitne changes hue, it's amazing. I tell you a classic example, we fund construction equipment. Construction equipment were taxed at 28%. Now, I was okay. I mean, people were trying to present the construction equipment industry, this is body that I think of. They were representing up to level pe, they log gaye, Ministry of Heavy Industries, sab jagah mila hai ki sir ye wo hai, we are the, you know, hum log infrastructure bana rahe hain aur hum se zyada tax le rahe hain. Kai baar kya hota hai, you have to knock the right door. I told them in such forum they were talking, then I told them, I said, boss, we are knocking the wrong door. Government has created 12 sectoral groups. So opportunity lies in failure. That I see.
For the enlightenment, I hope it will help us in our academic as well as corporate careers. As we approach to the end of this lively and fruitful session, I request our Pro Vice Chancellor, Pradeep Sir, and our Dean, Prusty Sir, to present a memento to our eminent guests. Please have a round of applause again. Now I request the Dean Sir, Dr. Sadananda Prusty, to propose the vote of thanks.
Good afternoon to one and all present here. First of all, listening to such an eminent personality, and we are given this opportunity by Professor Pradeep Sir because he has invited him, and I can say in a nutshell that all of our dream has come true after listening to the eminent personality, Honorable Shri Raman Aggarwal ji. May I request the audience, please give a huge round of applause for him. First, no resume, I can say that being an economics professor, I learned a lot, and I know that because of the time constraints, sir has not given all the details. Otherwise, he is having all the information, and that's the reason which our university is preaching for now. That means we should have a happy blending between theory and practice. I think because of Professor Pradeep sir's initiative, and that has come true, okay? And this would not have been possible because all the opportunity without the support, without the encouragement of our Honorable Chancellor sir, VC ma'am, and especially Professor Pradeep sir, okay? So may I request the audience, please give a huge round of applause for them. And thanks to all my faculty colleagues who are present here and listening to the eminent personality. And also I would like to thank our student activities coordinators, Ms. Manisha Singh and Mr. Jitendra Kumar. They are coordinating with our student volunteers and me and ensure that this lecture is a successful one. So once again, I'm thanking to both these student coordinators. And last but not the least, I'll do injustice if I will not thank my student volunteers and our students, participants. Without your presence, this lecture would not have been organized. So hence, thank you all for your presence here, and I hope that all of you might be benefited because of Raman sir's lecture. And I'm sure as I gained, he has explained so nicely all these concepts. I think that's the reason because we have given some of this, like your students used to ask at the beginning. So we'll ask sir, these are the questions. I think after all these things you have explained so nicely, sir, that's the reason you are finding that all the students, I think most of the things, it is a storytelling mode and it is so educative that all my students, they benefited a lot and they got all this clarity. And I will also thank Mr. Kamranji, who is present here, taken the snaps and videos for our GU Facebook uploading. Thank you, Mr. Kamranji, okay, for your support. And once again, I thank you all that because of you only, this lecture, I can guess that it is a successful one. And if I miss someone's name, it's my apology. Once again, thank you all.